Gotta love it when things don't go to plan, eh? Basically, haven't managed to get an address sorted out for my new place, and I don't think I'm gonna bother, if you know what I mean. And I'm gonna basically do a quick recap video and explain why I've been absent for 5 weeks. So basically, I've just granted myself like a dangerous new level of freedom by coming out here in pretty much every sense of the word. You know, financially as much as anything else. Basically, I don't pay rent, obviously. But you've got to be in the right sort of mindset. I wasn't prepared. I hadn't been working on the abundance mindset. You'll hear people who do manifestation talking about the abundance mindset, and I understand that we're creating our reality with our thoughts and our beliefs. Long story short, I was riding around on basically my dream bike, which I've built for a ridiculously small sum of money considering what it is. It's basically built out of secondhand parts. Just got them on eBay. I've got this, you know, fairly decent laptop. I'm running a YouTube channel now, which is something I've wanted to do for ages, just to get what's in my head out. It's like therapy, really. And also I'm living in this amazing place. I'm having this experience, which it was almost too much. I was out there for 3 days and then it was my birthday. So I was riding to mum and dad's place to go and see the folks. You know, I haven't really celebrated my birthday for several years. It just hasn't been a big deal for me. Didn't really mean a lot. I'm one of those types, do you know what I mean? But there was just this feeling. It was a lovely day, kind of like it is today. And it's gonna sound crazy, but I'm gonna get pretty crazy on this channel in the near future. I'm gonna talk about this more and more, but there is something from the other side. I don't know where it comes from or what it is, but it's like I can feel it right now as I'm talking. It wants me to say these things. And it all got a little bit too fucking real all of a sudden, right? And like I say, the dangerous levels of freedom, not least of all the financial freedom. And as I was riding, I saw this, like the numbers speak to me. I see number plates all the time with sequences of numbers. So I saw this number plate and it was quite probably the best number plate I've ever seen. It was simply 3434D or 3434D. And it was my 34th birthday. So to see that number twice was pretty significant. My birthday is 2102, and then you take the year that we're currently in, 2018, and you take all these numbers and you add them up, and if you get a double number, you add them together, and it tells you what, this is numerology, this gives you the number of the year you're in. So I'm in a 7 year. 3 and 4 added together make 7, so it was saying to me 7-7 as well. And, you know, I don't know the significance of the D. I'm hoping 34D, that's kind of hinting at the physical dimensions of my future lover. That would be pretty cool. So your spirit guides are talking to you in no uncertain terms, if you know what to look for. I suddenly found myself with all this abundance, like I say, the bike, the computer, I'm out of the rent trap. Yeah, the next day I got the train, and I was on the train with my mum and her friend. We all got the train together. I got off the train, and I went and got a haircut, and when I'd had my haircut, I realised that I didn't have my bag anymore. I thought I'd left it in the barber's, but when I went back there, it wasn't there. And basically, I found out that I'd left it on the train. And I was just like, what the fuck? What the fuck does this mean? Does it mean I'm not supposed to do YouTube? Does it mean I'm not supposed to talk about this stuff? Does it mean I'm not supposed to share this journey I'm going through? You know, and talk about synchronicity, talking about somehow the universe is trying to communicate with us and trying to push us in the right direction, let's say. I was in the supermarket. This is after losing my gear. I was back in town to see mum and dad. I've lost all my gear and I'm pretty crestfallen about the whole thing. And I was just walking down the aisle, walking down towards the tills, and this guy came around the corner. And his face lit up and immediately became very animated and he started moving towards me. And I thought, who the fuck is this? I don't recognize him. He must have seen someone behind me who he knows. So I was like, okay, but he was definitely coming up to me. And he was like, you know, I figured he knows my face, but he doesn't know my name. You know, it's not a very catchy name, is it, my frequencies? But I thought, that's it, he's a YouTube subscriber. And I said, my frequencies, and he's like, yeah, that's right, I've been watching you for a while. And he was one of my earliest subscribers, and his name was Mark. And he was there with his partner, Philippa. And they'd come over from the neighboring county, so they hadn't come far, but they were on holiday, and they just happened to be in the same, you know, vague area as I was, you know, just happened to be where I was. I think, you know, his enthusiasm for what I'm doing, and they've got off-grid ambitions of their own. They currently live in a house at the moment, but I think they said they've got three kids. The eldest is Ellie, and apparently Ellie watches the channel, so hi Ellie. Hi Mark and Philippa, thank you very much for watching. It's going to be in the future that they get to pursue that, maybe when the kids have grown up a little bit more. So that was it. Basically, that meeting with Mark and Philippa made me think, right, there must have been a reason why I lost all my gear. But at the same time, I'm still supposed to continue doing this thing. So I got back to the grindstone, and I started earning money again and buying my freedom from Babylon. That's how it's felt. What else did I lose? I lost my external hard drive, which had a lot of pictures that connected me to the past. I lost all the master files for all the videos I've done up to this point. I lost a lot of research notes, lots of stuff like this, lots of stuff about diet and nutrition. Generally speaking, just stuff that connected me to the past. It's like an enforced fresh start, maybe. Just a clearing out of stuff in my head. All right, it was a good old ramble. I'm gonna get on and do the rest of the ride now, get home, and then, yeah, I did actually shoot a little bit with my phone when it was snowing, so I'll probably put that in right here.
I can't fucking believe it, guys. They did threaten us with this, but it has snowed again. And it's, you can see on the logs here, it's about 3 inches already. And it's still coming down like a motherfucker. It's just after 6 a.m. I just got up with the intention of going to work. It wasn't actually snowing too bad when I came in last night. In fact, it wasn't snowing at all. It wasn't snowing. Wasn't raining, but here I am, I'm trapped again. I've got to capture some of the madness of being trapped out here in the snow. Yeah, look at it. It is quite beautiful, but this is a fucking pain in the ass. It's mad, isn't it? And everything's so fucking quiet because the snow sort of muffles the sound. So here's the trail that I used to get in and out. It's almost obscured, but not quite. But if I go out there, especially with the bike, I'm gonna leave tracks that will be really easy to follow. It's very beautiful. So I'm gonna get a lot of work done today. Got my thermometer outside now. It's 4 degrees, so as soon as it stops snowing, this shit will start melting, right? Because ice doesn't like 4 degrees. Oh, that's some lovely fluffy powder though, isn't it? For all you snow surfers out there. And I've been living out here about a month now. This is probably, was it like the 17th or the 18th today? So I think it's been about a month. It's amazing.